Welcome to Casa Cangrejo, our luxury villa in Tulum, Mexico. After a two-year wait, we finally moved in. Was it all worth it? Let's take a tour and you be the judge. Hey everyone, Andy and Trey here. Before we take you on a tour, we thought we'd share a little bit about us and how we got here.
Back in 2020, during the pandemic, we got married on the beach here in Tulum and pretty much found this jungle community here in town on a whim. We looked at dozens and dozens of properties, and Flora Fauna, where we are now, is the only one that checked all the boxes for us.
After the pandemic, having our own private pool and plenty of outdoor space to entertain were on the top of our list. We've always lived in condos in major cities for work, so we were excited to find an entire house for less than the cost of our condo in San Francisco, Chicago, and even all of the condos we looked at in expat-popular Puerto Vallarta.
We also wanted a community with solid infrastructure. Flora Fauna has underground electricity, fiber optic internet, as well as city water and sewer services. There aren't any power lines hanging everywhere. There's also no HOA. However, there is an optional private security service that is directly connected to the local police, as well as emergency healthcare services.
We also love this specific location within Flora Fauna. We are the only center home in the community facing the park, so we have beautiful views every morning walking down our stairs.
Our next door neighbor is also one of the best hotels in town, the fabulous Hotel Bardo, where we like to enjoy pool days or sunset cocktails with friends.
Another one of our favorite places in Tulum is Palma Central, Tulum's gastronomic food truck park. It's just a few blocks away from us.
Also in walking distance are popular restaurants, markets, and gyms like Burrito Amor, Real Coconut Kitchen, Gypsy Market, and the Tulum Jungle Gym Pueblo, all not to be missed.
We're also looking forward to the recently announced entry of Uber into Quintana Roo, as well as the Maya Train and Tulum Airport, which is going to be located just a few minutes south of us. The train and airport are expected to open this year and next.
Tulum is definitely playing catch up with its infrastructure, but things are improving rather quickly. For example, where we're located on the south side of Tulum, there is now direct access to the beach along Avenida Kukulcan, which is known as the New Beach Road. So that's super exciting. We can now bike or drive down to the beach in about 15 or 20 minutes. We've also heard on the Old Beach Road, Avenida Coba, that there is going to be a tram from Pueblo or town to the beach, so that should make parking much easier.
Another plus is that our developers bought a beach club called Cinco in the national park during the pandemic, so you can often find us relaxing there. With that introduction and overview out of the way, let's start the tour.
Upon entry, you'll first notice the open floor plan and floor-to-ceiling windows throughout. We have a dining room table for six made by local carpenters from local wood. Nearly everything in Casa Cangrejo was made locally here in Mexico, except for maybe the couch and the TV. We have a fully equipped kitchen with Samsung inverter fridge and a Whirlpool six-burner gas range and oven.
Another really cool feature we added in the kitchen is a water pump, so we can drink water and use ice directly from our fridge. It attaches to the large blue jugs we have delivered in bulk once a month for just 40 pesos each, which is about $2.
Down this hallway, we have the downstairs half bath and the laundry room. The half bath opens to an outdoor shower with both hot and cold water. Finally, at the end of the hall, there is the laundry room with a front-loading Samsung washer and gas dryer, as well as a huge storage area tucked neatly beneath the stairs.
Now, let's head to the living room where we have an oversized, comfy couch and 65-inch Samsung TV connected to our blazing-fast Starlink internet. We also added a battery backup for any short power outages in Tulum, so we'll stay connected.
Also, all of the doors in Casa Cangrejo slide open and have screens for the ultimate in indoor-outdoor living.
Heading outside, we have a covered dining area with a ceiling fan.
Back by the pool, we added four loungers so our guests will all have their own place to enjoy a cocktail in the sun. The pool is made of chikung, which is a beautiful local building material, which you'll find on a number of the interior walls inside the house.
We also added three hand-carved Mayan stone fountains to round out the lush, tropical Tulum vibe of the villa. We love the way the various pool, garden, and wall lighting work together to illuminate the backyard at night.
Back inside, let's head up the polished concrete and then floating stairs to the second level, where we have two king-size bedrooms as well as a flex space with a day bed. In the flex space, we also have the entryway lighting and views to the park. It's such a plus for us to not have another view of a house or even a concrete wall when coming down our stairs each morning.
For the guest bedroom, again, there is a king-size bed and two hanging lamps. We added a USB and USB-C outlet here and many spots throughout the house. All of the bedrooms come equipped with individual inverter AC units with touchscreen operation. There's also a huge wardrobe made from local Chechen wood. Just outside the guest bedroom is a full bathroom, complete with a rain shower and huge chikung bathtub. Bathtubs are a rarity in Tulum, so we also added one mainly for Trey's mom, who loves a hot bath.
Now let's head into the primary suite. The first thing you'll notice is the king-size floating Mayan stone headboard that dominates the room. We like to wake up at sunrise to watch the colorful clouds float by and listen to the birds. This is the sunny side of the house, so we also installed blackout curtains in case we want to sleep in.
We also added a desk for any guests that may need privacy for remote work. And for any spouses that use the guest bedroom as their closet, like Trey did back in Chicago, this huge wardrobe has dual hanging closets on opposite sides for both of you. Stepping into the primary bathroom, there are two sinks and two rain showers as well. There will be no fighting over the sink when getting ready at Casa Cangrejo, and no one has to be cold when showering together.
All right, we have one last surprise for you, and that's taking you up to the roof deck. At the top of the stairs, before we head outside, there are vents at the top of this door to allow the heat to escape through the stairwell. Out on the roof, we tiled it just like all of the other outdoor spaces for that indoor-outdoor flow, and we added this beautiful bench here to enjoy a nice glass of wine at sunset.
The roof is also where the mechanicals and our gas tanks are located. There is a huge water cistern under the parking that pumps water up here. So even if we lost power in a storm, we have gravity to allow us to be able to use water for about 2 weeks. So that's it, a tour of our jungle villa in town called Casa Cangrejo.
Our plan is maybe to spend half a year in Mexico using Casa Cangrejo as our home base for travels. When we're away, you'll find Casa Cangrejo on Airbnb via our amazing local superhost. We've rented from her a number of times during our build process. If you're interested in renting our villa, Casa Cangrejo, we'll add an Airbnb link for you in the description below.
When we are here, you may find us on Mr. B&B, which is like Airbnb for the LGBTQ community. We've rented on Mr. B&B many times throughout our travels, and it's a great opportunity to get a local's perspective, and it's been super fun meeting people from all over the world.
We've also made a number of videos on moving to Mexico and travel guides around Mexico, so we'll add links to those in the description below as well. We've covered topics like permanent versus temporary residency, to navigating the Cancun airport, to where to eat in Oaxaca. So definitely check those out as well.
Well, that's it for this video tour of our new house. If you have any questions, please drop them in the comments below.
And if you enjoyed this video, do us a favor and smash that like button for the almighty YouTube algorithm and consider subscribing to our channel.
Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you on the next adventure.
Hasta luego.